lunch menu. Just going to show you some of the tropical vegetation here in the Darwin area. This one grows fairly common, these trees. If you can see these trees here, they don't seem to have any branches like the one here, not many. And although this might be a young tree, but it's a sign of a cyclone. Another view from the beach side, the beach here in Darwin. This is the fish feeding. Here the fish is swimming in every morning, expecting some food. Darwin. Still building some new buildings. You know, Darwin was flattened in 1974. Termit again. Well, they got on them here. Catherine Gorge National Park at sunset, and perhaps you can see the rainbow just over there. It's very green over here. It's raining a lot. This is the rainy season This is how the Aboriginal lives. Their huts. And this is a typical Australian farmhouse. This was this is a replica of from the film We in the Never Never. That's the bed, and here you see an armchair, some other furniture. And the walls doesn't go quite up, so there's air coming in there. And this is corrugated iron roof. And we're walking through some Australian jungle. And this pool is about 34 degrees hot Celsius.
Is it? Dry.
This is an rather unusual stone or mountain, I don't know what you call it. And this is Tennant Creek. And it's the center of the town. This is Devil's Marbles, south of Tennant Creek. All these unusual big rocks and stones here. This is typical windmill. It's pumping up water into the tank, as you can see there. And these hills are rather flat, all of them. This is just a little north of Alice Springs. You can see the road is just straight. It's bush country. This is the Tropic of Capricorn circle there. Alice Springs was first just a telegraph station. This is the one here. Later, more and more people came and built it a town, which is a few kilometers away from this place. There it is again. You can close up.
Can I get a photo of you with the camera?
Oh, really?
Well, someone might come and have a ride with that one. Grab bun.
gosh. It's like a sheep.
Yeah.
Well, this is less than 1 hour old, this camel baby. Just trying to rise now. Wants to go to her mama. Mother gives encouragement to stand on his leg for the first time.
can. I can.
And this is Ayers Rock that you see just over there. This is a cave, and inside here is paintings, and this is some of the paintings by the Aboriginals. Looks like a boat to me. And that's an arrow. And here is some more paintings. That's a man. Of course, this is a history.
and this is a sacred site for the Aboriginal. Actually, this looks like an Aboriginal in profile.
An Aboriginal hut. This is how they live. This is the men's meeting place. This is the morning sunrise, and now you will see the rock changing its color for a few moments. Hey. This morning the sky was a little cloudy, so we didn't get that bright coloring as it usually does. Yes, you are seeing people that are climbing up on the rock, and they're holding on to a wire or a rope it takes them nearly an hour to climb up, and the only thing they can hold on to is that rope. And they're still climbing on, and it is dangerous, as you have seen. Some people have lost their lives. This is Cooper Pedy in South Australia. This is where they dig out opals. And people live there also. They're cutting the caves, and they live up here in the hills. Unfortunately, this mine is closed, or the door is closed, so we can't get in here. And this is just an open hole.
there is another mine opened for people to come in and have a look. And there's many of these small ones, as you see here. Many onto the horizon. For the next 30, 40 kilometers, there's a lot of those small ones around. And here is a professional worker. It's digging there. What could that be? How many carat? And he could. Oh yeah, maybe. Oh yeah, look. Of course, as you can see there, the professional digger has got a big machine to her help too. We are following this professional opal digger. What does it say on the chain? Free opal. Well, it surely is a good way of finding some opal. Much easier here, isn't it, than digging out there in the fields in the heat. Just showing you some vegetation here. Just showing you a little bit of salt here. This is natural salt lakes. There's many of them in South Australia. And here is a piece of salt. It's where the sugar meets the salt. Salty. Just showing again how empty this area is. There's no people around. We've driven now 480 kilometers and only a couple of villages we've been through. Not much traffic, one car every now and then. And now we are in South Australia, the southern parts, between Port Augusta and Peterborough. And the hills are very typical. And so are these ruins that you see here. Very common sight in South Australia. And the windmill, you see. Typical. Thank you.
here they're growing either wheat or some other thing here. Hey Millie. This is Sydney. Kevin is doing just a series on Sydney.
Just do three or four, because I've got a couple of paintings inside I've got to work on.
Okay. One will do, Kevin.
Oh, no, I'll do.
You just
tell me when you're ready to start.
Yep, I'm starting now.
You want me to describe it?
Yes, please.
You know, these are just the little Gideon's testaments, because I'm a member of the Gideon's, and they're... very easy for people to carry around, and there's another ones here I do is a little new international version of the New Testament. Quite good, and they're a nice colour. I just usually paint a few wildflowers on them. And people don't throw them away; they read them.
Oh yes.
And I think we've given away 700 odd since last year.
Yeah.
Which is quite good.
Specially chosen people or
no, just what the Lord leads.
Yeah.
You know, I don't give them away to give them to people, but if somebody turns up, I say, would you like a little testament? And just give them to them. And there's quite a two Americans got saved through giving them two one day, and they told the Gideons how they got in touch with the Gideons and said how they found the Lord out of the two of the testaments. So it really pays off. And I give a lot away overseas. I'm overseas. The other day we had opportunity to give some away over at, in Japan, and it's quite good. It's quite a good ministry because I don't print, but I was painting one day the Good News, something similar to this one, and I happened to flick it open, and as I was painting it, it just flew open, and I seen the words. It was in.
All right. Now you're doing this a series of scriptures. You said.
I've been doing it since 1962.
Yeah.
But they've only just started taking notice of the galleries.
And in this style, all the same.
Yeah.
And
most of the galleries stereotype. They're only interested in paintings that sell.
Yeah.
You see.
And as you said, you've done several. And this is the dissension.
I've done dozens.
Dozens, yeah.
Yeah, they're all over the there have been a lot been sold, but there's this is a recent one, and I've done a few. I'm working on a couple more of the same, but they're only just starting to take notice of them after all those years.
Yeah. And here are some emus.